Panchashikshakshapati is a
yes,
next order it has come.
Now we have been considering why the master has given two qualifications first and this good conduct for purification or Shatsampati, or you call it Panchashila, you call it Ten Commandment, you call it Yam Niyam, moral code, good conduct. At the third point. Why? Because if without discrimination, without understanding, you are following blindly a particular code of morality and good conduct, then it will be a problem for you, for us. At that level, without, if you are following without understanding, we will find most difficult thing. Say for example, if you tell a young man, don't have any desire, don't have any ambition, he'll say, you are foolish. Why without ambition of work? What can I do? So even if he, because if he respects the speaker, he says, oh, my elder brother says like that, so I must follow it. I should not have ambition, I should not have any desire. And then whenever desire comes, we suppress it. Because someone else, someone superior or elder brother is following. So he is suppressing the desires. It's more dangerous. That's why Master says that when you really develop discrimination and you really know why you should not have desire. Because desires are binding, desires are creating problems, desires are creating depressions and stress, strain and tension and so many problems. That's why when with the understanding of that insight or that discrimination faculty, it will be easy for us to walk on the right path. Let us take an example. In the world there are persons, we are also having in the world, we have been earning money. At that time, if someone would have told us, no, don't earn money, don't run after money, don't run after wealth and power, we could not have understood it. Even if out of respect, if he give up certain things, it would have been by suppression, which is more harmful. But when we grown up, we develop understanding, there is some discrimination, and we believe it that there are more important things than these wealth and power. There is a spiritual wisdom, there is intuitive wisdom, there are the higher level of spirituality, which is more blissful, which is more joyful, which is more wonderful enlightenment. Then naturally these things will go away automatically. I'll give you an example. When we were child, we used to play with the toys, everybody, when we were child. If someone will try to snatch away our toys, we will cry. We will not allow to keep, correct? So you make a big lecture to the child, no, don't play with these toys, this and that, and snatch away the toys and book, give him the book. He will throw away the book and will try to away and catch the toy. This is general tendency. But when he grew up, he understood, no. Study is a useful thing. If I don't study, I will not have a good job, I will not have a good earning, I will not be respected in the society, I will be a tougher, I will have to work like a laborer. When he understands this thing a little bit, that study is useful, education is very useful, so he himself will throw away the toys. And throwing away the toys will not be a painful process for him. Why? Because now he has understood. Let us take another example. Suppose you have a diamond. You thought it is a diamond, a very precious jewel, say 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs, or there are jewels for 10 crores also. You understand this is a jewel and 10 crores value. What will you do it? You will keep it in the safe custody. If someone wants to take it, you will not allow him to take. Right? If some whatever thing may, but you will try to put it in the safe custody, in the lock. You will not put it anywhere carelessly because it's a very precious to you. But one fine morning, my jeweler comes to you and says, hey, this is not a jewel, this is not, this is artificial stone. Oh, this is artificial, it has no value. Even then, will you put it into locker? No. Even then, you will take so much care of it. You won't care because now you have understood this is just a stone. Similarly, wealth, power, possessions, name, fame, worldly empires is so attractive, so precious to us in the beginning that we can't afford to give it up. But when we understood, oh, these are the temporary things, they are more permanent things, more blissful things, more higher things. So let us try for that. Because time and energy is limited. So at will, willfully, joyfully, it's not a painful process for us. Some of us, we have left job. Some of us, we are not caring for the earning. Some of us are still engaged in earning. They are still giving preference to cash and power because they have not understood it. The moment when they will understand it, like some of us, we have understood it. So automatically it's left drop. That's why the discrimination and desirelessness have kept in the first place. And one more thing I'll tell you here, that these qualifications are not one by one. First you have the 100% discrimination, then you will have the 100% discretion, then you will have the 100% good quality. It's not like that. It's all interlinked. Little bit discrimination. Everybody knows what is right, what is wrong, to some extent. Even a totally uneducated person, a savage person, he also knows that he should not kill his wife, he should not slap his child, he should not harm his relatives. Many things he knows. He knows many things by birth. Things instinctively he knows. So, whatever he knows, then he put it into practice. When he will put into practice, he will know more. His clarity will become still more. And then it will be more clear, clarified, then he will be able to put into practice as a good conduct furthermore. The more he purified himself, the more discriminating he become, the more discriminating he become, more dispassionate he become. So this is a virtuous circle. It's not that first you complete one chapter and close it, then you take up the second chapter. But it goes together. It's interlinked. It's just like a ring. It has got no end here. And you can start. In fact, you can start from anywhere. If you don't want to start from the discrimination, you follow the code, even then you will come to know. Because when you are leading a clean life, even without understanding, because some moral code has been given to us, that we must follow, there are some universal norms, we should follow it. Even if we are following without understanding, it will also give some positive effect. But if we follow it with understanding, then it will give a better effect. That's why discrimination has been kept on the first point. We are again and again harping on discrimination and desirelessness, then the good conduct will not be a problem for us. Like one point, we are going to take control of mind, say for example, control of mind. How difficult it is. You can control the whole world, you can win the thousands battle, but you cannot win your own mind. Lord Buddha says, one can win the thousands battle, but to win our own lower self, our own lower mind, man ko jeetna kitna mushkil hai. Bade bade maharathi man ko jeetne ke liye fail ho jaate hain. Arjun was a great warrior. He could kill the thousands and thousands enemies, but he could not control his own mind. And he raised the question to Lord Krishna, sir, it's very difficult to control the mind. It runs away like air. ये वायु के वेग के समान भागता है नजर. How difficult it is. जब अर्जुन ये कहते हैं तो हम लोग बहुत छोटे आदमी हैं. हमारे लिए कितनी बड़ी प्रॉब्लम होगी. How difficult it would have been for us to control the mind. So we must be well equipped. If we are going to into the war to fight with the enemy, we must be equipped well. Without preparation, if we are entering into the battlefield, we will be killed automatically. So we are there to fight. So when we are going to fight with our mind, we are going to fight with our ambitions, and we are going to fight higher those things, then we must be well equipped by discriminating faculty, by insight, by understanding, by wisdom. It will help us then.